Hey, here we are again. The Pulse of Brattleboro back in action after a winter hiatus. Joe's back. Say hi, Joe. Hey, there's Joe over the truck sound. But here we are back on Main Street for another gallery walk. It's a Friday night in Brattleboro, first Friday of the month. And the month is April. So here we are, and we're getting closer to that strolling of the heifers. So start paying attention, getting ready for that, too. We'll be out on the street for that one. But we're going to hit gallery walk today. A couple things I did want to put in people's minds is, number one, I want to thank everybody for helping us out, me and Richard, for the Windham County Heat Fund. Pretty successful year. We raised over $45,000, helped around 100 families stay warm. We couldn't have done it without you. Thank you very much, everybody. We appreciate it. And also, there's another thing going on. It's kind of under the radar, unless you're in Montpelier. And that's the, there's two things, really. The Velcro Crow lines that I think everybody should be paying attention to, which we might have passed the, we might have lost the opportunity to get a say in that, but I don't know. We still got Senator Galbraith, Uzi, and Ash up there working hard on that issue still. And then we have another one that's the CVPS and the merger with Green Mountain Power along with the Canadian firm there. We want to pay attention to that because we should have been, what is it, Hydro-Quebec? Yeah, that's right, Hydro-Quebec, Joe just said, which we just got done talking about actually with Senator Galbraith. And they're supposed to pay some money back to us, folks, and it ain't happening. You may, if you're a CVPS customer especially, here's an opportunity where you can get back maybe $75 to $155 as a rebate for this merger deal. So you may want to let your senators know that you are paying attention and that you do care. You do want that $16 million that was put as ours anyway. It's the ratepayers. So anyway, those are a couple things I just wanted people to get, start paying attention to anyway, because it's kind of in the news, but not really headlining. So here we are, back in Brattleboro, heading down Main Street. Going to see what's happening here on another gallery walk. Join us, will you? Another edition of the Pulse of Brattleboro right here on your TV set. On Main Street in front of the nice vehicle here, which can be won by a lucky individual. I am standing with, let's start this out first. I am standing with
Mary Bourne.
And
Mark Consign.
And why are we out here, Mary?
We're here to support rescue, and we're here raffling off this beautiful Subaru car, and that's why we're here, because we want to raise money for rescue.
Which is an excellent thing to be doing. As a person who started learning more about what happens at rescue and finding out how many things don't get funded, I sit at the hospital even, and when you guys go out sometimes, if you don't show up at the hospital, I go, there we go, we didn't get any money for rescue on that one. I mean, it's really amazing. People don't realize all the rules. So we really need to do this fundraising, folks, to help rescue, provide the services that they provide for all of the area here. I mean, and I think what you guys do, Mark, is unbelievable. Now, you've been in charge, I don't know your title exactly. What is your title?
I'm the Chief of Operations.
And you've been doing that now for how long?
I'm actually my 26th year at rescue.
Yeah, I know. You've been there a long, long time. Wow, yeah. Good for you, man. Good. Yeah. So just, expand a little bit on what I was saying. Like when you go out on a call, and if it's a Medicaid call or something like that, and it's not for transport, you just went out on a call for free, didn't you?
Well, and we actually only, for example, with Medicare, make about 60 cents on the dollar. So right out of the chute, we're actually behind the eight ball. And so anything that the agency can do to make up for the funding deficits, yeah, that's what we're all about. So this fundraising, the generosity of Subaru in getting on board and helping us with this project, this is another way that rescue can actually raise funds to help support the bottom line and, most importantly, help the 15 communities we serve.
Yeah, excellent, excellent. And this will help the bottom line. Now, Mary, how long have you been involved with rescue?
Well, I'm not on the board, but I've helped with miscellaneous fundraisers throughout the years. I did help sell tickets for the last car that they raffled off, and I was very the winning one. I was very excited.
You
are, because I've got it right here already. See, I'm not going to let go until you buy one. I might have to talk you into three. But
that's actually the way I want to go, but I didn't bring enough with me today.
Okay.
So you're going to let me buy the other two later, right?
Absolutely. I'd just like to reiterate what Mark was saying, that one of the things about rescue that I find very important is that they cover 15 communities. He just said 15. 15 is a big number. It's not just Brattleboro. They're outreaching. They reach way out beyond Brattleboro, and it's so important to know that people who are way out in the outskirts where it's hard to get to, rescue gets there.
And it's more than just that also. My mother-in-law, before she passed, rescue came and helped my father-in-law many times transport her to the hospital even. You know, to me, I mean, after listening to Marty talk about that, I didn't even know you guys did that kind of stuff. So, I mean, that's another reason. Rescue, I work at the hospital, as most people probably know, so I see you folks doing what you do all the time. And, I mean, you can't ask for a more professional group of people and volunteers is what we got here at Rescue. I mean, it's just unbelievable. So everything we can do is going to help them out. And one lucky person, and I hope that's me with this ticket right here, gets to go away with a car. Now, what is this is going to go to some specific stuff, right?
That's right. We've actually targeted three things, Daryl. Pediatric bag equipment enhancements, our monitored defibrillators, the cardiac monitors, which are very important.
Yeah, very important.
And also technology-wise with the tablet computers, now that everything is going electronic, all of our patient care reports are done electronically. So we're actually starting to do reports right out in the field. And the next generation would be tablet computers, which actually allow us to do it right at the patient side.
Which will probably tie in with all the other stuff that's going on.
That's right. So we'll be able to link in eventually right to the hospital. So our record that we create in the field will actually electronically go over to the hospital. And the hospital, as you know, is actually working on an electronic record platform. That's the wave of the future.
Yeah, you're darn right. Well, I'm going to get my ticket. But before I do that, we do have a trustee here. Leanne, come here. Leanne Boyd, who's been with Rescue, I don't know for how long, but... Geez, I'm Leon. I think it's been a...
I'm from the old rescue.
Yeah. Well, that was... Were you part of the building of it?
No, I was part of the growing of it back in 69.
Yeah, and when did we build it? It must have been right around there.
78 up on Canal Street.
Okay.
That building went in place.
So, Leon, were you there when it was at the Thompson House?
No, I came after that. And then they moved to Canal Street, the lower Canal Street. Where the old mobile station used to be. And then I got so involved with it when they moved up on the upper end of Canal Street where it is now present. And the thing of it is, you know, we 52 weeks a year, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, we're here for you. You call, I'll come to you. And if you got whatever your problem is, if we got something, we can fix it. We will fix it.
Yep. Well, I know you're a big supporter because every time I run into you, you're talking rescue. So thanks an awful lot, man, for being there.
Well, rescue has saved me. Many times, so
you're one of the people standing up.
I'm standing up, 2 feet on the ground, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week.
Excellent job. Thanks an awful lot. Get a good picture of the car here, Joe. And Lynn, do you want to say anything?
That not only can you buy a ticket here at Gallery Walk in person, or other events, we'll keep an eye out for where we're going to be, but you can actually go to the website. At www.rescueinc.org, you can go into Rescue Headquarters as well and buy tickets there, and you can actually call up and buy it over the phone.
Very good.
Okay.
Plenty of ways to get your ticket, folks. And please, and you can get three for $100 or one for $50. Okay, it's one for 50 or three for 100. I'm actually going to try and do the three for 100. I figure I get a free ticket that way. But anyway, We told you how to get a hold of them. Let's help them out. And whoever that lucky sucker is who's going to win this beautiful car, good for you. Now, is this from Brattleboro Subaru, by the way?
Yeah.
Oh, thank goodness. Okay, I can thank you, John, then. Thanks a lot, John Sharka, for helping us out in, as you usually do.
The winner will be announced July 4th at the fireworks.
And at the fireworks, July 4th. We will announce the winner of this beautiful car. And I think you heard 1,000 tickets. How many tickets? 1,500 tickets. So if we get rid of three for 100, you got less money they're getting, though, see?
And remember this, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, 52 weeks a year. You call, I'll come.
Yep. Well, if you don't come, he might. Somebody will be there. All right, Mark. Thanks an awful lot, man.
Yep.
You're better equipped for it.
Thanks, Leon.
Take care, buddy.
You bet.
I got to go talk to the kids.
Yeah. Okay, you ready? Okay, we are with...
Cara White.
I'm Keith Walsh.
Cody Collins.
And what are you guys doing out here? I'll start with you.
We are here to raise money to go to Costa Rica.
And why do you want to go to Costa Rica?
We're going to be studying the economy, coffee, cloud forests, and biodiversity.
Wow, what grade are you in?
We're in 8th grade.
And let me see. When will you be going for the trip?
We'll be going, I think, on the 1st of May.
This May?
Yes.
Wow. And are all three of you for sure going?
Yeah, the whole class is going. We have to raise money.
Whose class is it?
Marlboro Elementary School, the junior high.
Oh, Marlboro Elementary School, junior high?
Yeah.
Where's that at? Is that in that big red building?
No. It's like up if you go down Route 9. It's like this purple building.
On the left?
Yeah.
Okay, I know where it is. All right, I didn't even know they had that up there, you know. I thought you guys came down here. Wow, well, good for you. What have you learned about it? What's the climate?
It's warm, it's near the equator. It's very tropical.
Yeah, okay. All right, you guys, well, I hope you do it. I'm gonna donate. Since there's three of you sitting here, I'm gonna donate $3.
Thank you.
That's one for each of you anyway. That's not a lot, but hey, it's $3 more than you had. And I'm not even gonna take any food, unless Joe wants one of those. Because he's like almost drooling. Yeah, well, I may have to take one of them for Joe, so here's another dollar. All right, yeah. Here you go. Well, you're looking like you're doing all right. Good luck, okay?
Thank you.
Joe, grab one.
Well,
he loves chocolate. This guy just can't get enough chocolate. Thanks, you guys. Good luck.
All right, can I get a cupcake?
Yeah, all my donations.
Okay, how about I'll do $10.
Okay.
That's got my name all over it, I think. Are we ready? Okay, I'm standing with?
Emma Reuter.
And?
Sarah Williams.
See, I kind of fibbed a little, didn't I? Huh?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay, and what are you sitting here doing?
I am selling bake sale. Wait, no. I am supporting Hilltop Montessori School.
Is that what this is for?
Yes.
Okay. And this is to support Hilltop Montessori School to do what?
It's to support our two-year curriculum. So we go to Alabama 1 year, then Boston the next year. And in Alabama, we study the civil rights and meet, like, civil rights activists. And then in Boston, we have our religion study. So we meet, like, we go to temples and mosques and churches.
You go to Montessori School?
Yeah, so.
What grade are you in?
8th grade.
What grade does it stop? Whoops, I'm supposed to do this. What grade does it stop in?
8th grade. So
you're like the senior class.
Sure,
right?
Yes.
Well, good for you. Well, at least you're out here doing something, and I hope you're successful. It looks like I'm going to have to get something, though, but I don't know what yet. I'm going to.
And we also have a 50-50 raffle sale, too. So.
Oh, so all this is, we're going to go talk. We'll talk to him, too. Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
That. Excellent job.
Thanks.
I think I'm going to have to go with one of them. Ooh, that looks good. Okay. And you are?
I'm Dieter Brim.
And you're over here doing the 50-50 raffle?
Yeah, 50-50 raffle. If you win, you get half the money we make from the tickets.
Good. How are you doing on the sale so far?
Pretty good.
Good. Excellent.
Yeah.
All right. Good for you. Well, good luck.
I can't find myself.
by myself.
You're right there, man. I touched you. I found you.
I don't think so.
I had six kids, 1 year like that. She's doing quite well. She's traveling all around the world. I just let her go. Try to support her.
Well, I gotta say that there's nothing really much that you can do just sitting on the sidewalk and just basically standing there and just doing anything else. We're just saying some crappy jokes. But the only thing on it that I can think of is just playing guitar. Yeah. Ah, like this. And what happened? Who turned me off?
Jingle to say watch the Pulse of Brattleboro on BCTV. Can you do anything with that? Can you do
no.
something? You can't?
No, I'm sorry.
Okay, that's fine. Alright, nothing there? Nine. Can you write the old song? Thank you.
Hold it. Wait a minute. Check your mic.
Check your mic.
I didn't hear you. Check your mic.
Test. The quick brown fox jumped over the lazy dog's back.
Okay.
Okay. We're going to try again. You ready?
Yeah.
You are?
Gina Patterson.
And you are?
Karen Henry.
See, I tried to throw you off a little bit. Yeah. Okay, Karen, why are we out here?
Well, Gina and I are actually out here representing the United Way. We're both board members for the United Way of Windham County. And the circus is coming on May 12th. And all the proceeds are going to support the United Way in Putney at Landmark College. Right. And she knows more, too. So.
Okay, so $15 for adults, $8 for children. It's going to be at Landmark College in Putney. And this is the graduation performance of the students at NECA. So it's going to be great. Oh, wow. They have to do a performance in order to graduate. This is the performance. So.
Wow, that should be really something. I've watched these guys do some performances and guys and gals. And I'll tell you, it's very amazing. This would be a good show to come to right here, wouldn't you say? Yeah. And let's say, what's the date again?
May 12th, 7:30 p.m.
Very good.
And again, all proceeds to the United Way, Windham County.
Which does what?
Benefits many of the nonprofits in United Way. So
very good.
Windham County. County of the United Way. I meant of the Windham County.
That's
yes.
Right. See, this is way harder than you think. I mean, you know, it's way harder.
You're shaking my hand.
Well, I can. Okay, I'll shake yours. I don't want you to feel
thank
left out.
Thank
you very much.
Thank you.
Keep up the good work.
Thank
we like
you.
United Way. How's it going? It looks like it's going all right.
Going great.
Yeah, Gallery Walk's good. How's the Belgian waffles going, man?
That's they are
good.
Delicious.
They're a hit.
They're still
they're
cooking.
Totally
wow. Okay, we ready? I am standing with?
Hind Akil.
What's your name?
Hind Akil.
I like that. And you are?
Dave Mazur.
And why are you out here, Dave?
We're raising money for the BUHS photography trip. We were able to raise all the money last year to send 20-plus kids down to the Southwick Zoo. And all this money pays for the kids to get down there into the zoo, activities, lunch, all that stuff. We're raffling off tickets to win 13x19 prints of the student artwork. And it's a great trip. Gives the kids an opportunity to see animals they've never seen before and come home with some beautiful artwork.
Excellent. Now, have you made the trip before by chance?
I haven't. I wasn't here last year.
Oh, so this is going to be your first one?
Yes, I'm so excited.
That's cool. And where's it at?
It's I forgot the name of the school, but it's in the zoo, but it's in Massachusetts.
Very good.
All right. Well, keep up the good work.
Thank you.
Glad you're out here doing this, and it's for a good reason. You know, you're supporting yourselves to go on a trip. Excellent job.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Good job, Dave.
Thank you.
Waffles, buddy. Come on, we're talking about it. Connor, thirsty.
Whenever you're ready. You ready, Joe? Okay, I am with?
Zoe,
Julia,
Victoria,
Amanda.
Wow, nice names, girls. Nice names. Now, I heard you guys earlier when I was kind of cruising through. You were singing a song, and I thought it sounded really good. So I says, hey, let's get these guys on, and that's what we're going to do. So I want you to
sing the song or a song. Make sure you do it loud enough so you can all get around here and they can hear it and look into the camera.
Have fun. Yeah.
Thank you.
Good job, girls. Good job. I hope it comes out all right. There was a little loud noise going over that way, but we'll see. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
One more thing you got to do. You got to get together and say, watch. Now, listen. How old are you guys?
17.
So you're all, 14. You got a little, how old are you?
14.
You go to BUHS? Good. All right. Because then you should be able to remember this phrase. Watch the Pulse of Brattleboro on BCTV. It's going to be right there, okay? Watch the Pulse of Brattleboro on BCTV. I'm going to go 1, 2, 3. Look at that. You got to look at that. And I'm going to go 1, 2, 3. When I point, watch the Pulse of Brattleboro on BCTV. You ready?
Yeah.
1, 2, 3.
Watch the Pulse of Brattleboro on BCTV.
Excellent job, girls. Excellent job. Thank you.
Thank you.
We are that time is when we are and we are singing for our love.
Justice seeking.
We are justice seeking people. And we are singing for our lives. We are justice-seeking people, and we are singing for our lives. We are gentle, angry people, and we are singing for our lives. We are gentle and weak people, and we are singing for our lives.
Thank you very much. Thank you. That'll be on in a couple of weeks.
On what?
Chandler, Pulse of Brattleboro.
Hey, Joe Bushes!
Hey, I've got my cupcake at
you. Oh, yeah, that's what they
asked me. See you later, Phoenix. Good job, young
man. Yeah. Phoenix Lavender Kelly rocks.
Nice. That's the local cable access. Nice. That's local TV.
I wait for him to go like this. Like that. I am with
Elizabeth Johnson.
And Elizabeth, I just found out you're the new director for Kids Place.
I am. That's
great. I think they picked a perfect person for it. Tell us what's going on down there.
What's going on down there?
And where it is, so for the people who don't know where it is.
Oh, that's right, that's right. So it's on 20 Elliott Street below Hotel Pharmacy. And it's open Wednesday through Friday, 10 to 5, and Saturdays, 10 to 4. And right now what we have going on, we have free day next Saturday, April 14th. And we also are organizing for Circus Smirkus. That's coming up in July, and that's a big one. And it's supporting the youth group up in northern Vermont. And what else? Just lots of good stuff. Healthy snack on Fridays at the co-op. Just
fun place to
lovely,
be.
Lovely
what things. A nice indoor activity. Kids can come in and they can just raise a little cane.
Really. Oh, totally. You know? We have a castle and a boat and a townhouse and crafts. And
I get jealous when I go because I'm too big and stuff and I can't kind of climb through a lot of the stuff. But it's just so cool.
I know.
It is.
I'm sorry, you're too big.
That's all right. we got to get a big one for the big boys.
Right? Right. You're not the first person that said
that. I know. They got, you know, there's just so many things you can crawl through and stuff. So anyway, Kids Place, Wednesday through Friday, open Saturdays from when again?
10 to 4.
And come down, see the new director who's been here since actually last year, but new to from what I found out today. So anyway, thank you for doing it.
Thank you so much.
Everything else is going well.
See you soon.
You bet. Take care. Your son wanted you to.
Thank you so much.
Super duper volunteer.
Helen Schwartz.
Helen, and I like to make sure that you get to say your name. But
okay.
Hey, Ken. Helen, you
Helen.
Have...
Helen. You want to start that again?
No. Hey, we'll cut that out.
I'm sorry, Ellen. That's okay. That was bad on my part.
It's Ellen Schwartz.
Yeah, I know Ellen. I know Ellen. I don't know where that came from.
He knew that.
So Ellen, you've been a very strong advocate for, well, putting people first. Let's go right here. And with the workers group there. What is coming up now, okay, on May 1st?
So on May 1st, we're going to have a big rally up in Montpelier in support of a people's budget, which is a budget that puts the needs of people first. Those would be needs like health care, housing, food, transportation, and also putting the needs of the planet first. So things like public transportation or safe passage for pedestrians and bicyclists so that we're less dependent on fossil fuels. Another one of our human needs is for things like childcare for working parents. So we're bringing together people from all over the state, along with some partner organizations like 350 Vermont and the Early Educators United, in a huge rally up in Montpelier. We're going to start at City Hall and march to the State House. There's going to be music, there's going to be kids' activities, there's going to be speakers, there's going to be fun. And the whole point of this is to show the legislature and show Vermont that how many thousands of people around our state really support putting the needs of people first rather than things like corporate greed. We don't have a lot of money. The large corporations have a lot of money. The insurance companies have a lot of money. But what we have is thousands of Vermonters. So that's what we're doing. We're going to bring lots of people up to Vermont. And there's already hundreds of people signed up, and hundreds more, I'm sure, are going to go. It's on May 1st, which is May Day. And the other thing about this year's rally is that it's a national day of action for the 99%. So we're coordinating with people all around the country who are doing similar kinds of rallies in their states in support of the needs of ordinary people, which is what the 99% is.
Very good, Ellen. Thank you for being involved again and doing a lot of the groundwork to make sure people do get involved. Because as a former legislator, the one thing I can really tell you is people do make a difference. Yeah. But you got to show up.
Yeah.
For that lawn to be filled, we'll say something. It's a Tuesday, is it?
It's a Tuesday.
Yeah, May 1st is a Tuesday. So if you can make it up there, folks, please. This is your voice. This is you talking. If you're one of the 99%, hey, if you're happy and everything's going good, then stay home. But if you got a few issues and you care about some of the things that Ellen's talked about, then try and make it up there, folks, because it does make a difference, and you can show the citizen legislature that the people are there to get some action. And I think that'll really matter a lot. So good work.
Thank you. Let me just tell people how they can sign up for a carpool, because we're going to be running carpools up from Brattleboro. The best way to do that is go to the Vermont Workers Center website, which is www.workerscenter.org. And if you go on there, you'll find a place where you can sign up to show up on May 1st. And when you do that sign up, there'll be a place where you can indicate that you want to be part of a carpool. And we'll get in touch with you. That information will come down to the local people, and we'll get in touch with you about being part of a carpool.
Thank you. Very
good.
Thank you,
Darryl.
Thanks a lot.
Okay. Take care.
You too.
Thanks a lot. Okay. Onward.
Nice job. Onward to the next. Okay. All right, we are with
Dennis Wigmans.
And Dennis, you, I know, are with the basic group.
Right, bring a skate park to town.
Hopefully, anyway. It's been quite a little battle, but we're getting closer and closer.
Yes, we are.
Every day. So the first question I want to ask is, how's it coming and where are we at in the process?
So far, so good. We've been before the Development Review Board. We got our permits for that. We've made it over most of the hurdles with the town, and we've raised $65,000 so far, which is a great start. We've got a few more years to get to that $300,000 goal, and we're starting to write grants and reach out to local people and see how they can help us out.
Yeah, I think once everything starts to look a little smoother, the money will start flowing a little more too.
Definitely.
That's my opinion. Now listen, we got an event, and we're going to be on in May, but I want to start promoting now. We got something coming up in June that I want people to start knowing about and getting aware of.
Right, on June 21st, we have the International Go Skateboarding Day. It's an international event held in countries worldwide. Same day, June 21st, we're going to do it up at the Crow Lot. There'll be vintage skate gear show where we're going to show off some vintage skateboards and you know, jerseys and that sort of thing. And also some contests for the kids, a couple maybe lessons for the young ones, that kind of thing.
Yep, very good. Anything else? And it's free. That's right. It's at the Crow Rock.
Exactly.
So come on, have fun. And we've had two of them already up there, and they've both been a blast.
Yeah.
Is Catarount Mount Ramps going to be present?
We don't know yet. We haven't, you know, finalized all the details yet.
Yeah.
Hopefully.
We'll give him a good plug anyway, though, just for the heck of it. All right, Dennis. Well, thanks a lot for your good hard work. And
I'd like to just say, if you want to send us a donation, they are
tax
deductible.
Oh, yeah, that's right. That's what I wanted to
They are tax deductible. You can send it to the Rec and Parks Department here in Brattleboro. Make out the check to the town of Brattleboro with the skate park in the memo line, and ask them to send you a receipt so you can get a tax deduction on it.
See, it's a good thing we practiced this before.
There you go.
Right? I forgot about the main part.
Right?
Good job, Dennis. Thanks
a
lot.
Take care.
Keep it going, Joe. Keep it going. We're going to go right over here to Senator White, who's out here selling I Am Strong, which I just got my plate. I'm so happy I got my plate.
I know. It's about time.
Hey, Maria.
I know.
Maria, one of BCTV's finest behind me. She's hiding from the camera.
She just made a little ad here to put on.
Oh, did she?
Yeah, she did.
The girl, she's always doing stuff, man. I'm telling you, she's like the BCTV volunteer extraordinaire. You name it, she does it.
I know.
She's been here longer than I've even been around here. You know what I mean? So
plates,
Senator, let's sell some plates.
Sell some plates. $25.
Yep.
$18 to the victims of Irene. $2 to the Vermont Food Shelf. $5 for the manufacturer of the plate.
We don't do them in the prison system anymore?
We do, but we pay them. And they cost something for the metal.
Okay.
Yeah.
I think we're overpaying them, but okay.
Yeah, well, they don't
pay $5. But that's still good. I'm just picking on you, Senator.
Right.
We need another study.
Oh, thank you. No, we don't need any more studies.
Okay.
And we need to sell, well, the goal is 50,000. And I think we're right on target. I don't know.
I bet we make it.
They're ahead of where they thought they were going to be, but I am shamelessly hawking these. I did it.
You are.
I know. I did it at town meeting. I'm tripping people. I'm making them come and buy
plates. But it's for such a good cause. It's unbelievable.
For such a good cause. And you can keep them on your front of your car until 2014, and then you have to take them off.
But then they're collectibles.
They're collectibles. If you get them off by 2014, because there's a little chip in here that'll blow up your car on July 1st of 2014 if you don't take them off.
She's kidding.
No,
okay.
I am kidding.
She's kidding. Because here, you can have mine back. I might have got one with a malfunction. I don't want the chip to go off too early.
No. Well, it's not a chip. There's not a chip in there at all.
Listen.
You have to take them off by then.
And this is a great great idea.
Oh, and
really.
There goes somebody who needs to buy one, Ned.
Yeah,
come on,
Ned.
You need to buy one of these. $25. Come on.
All right. So, Senator.
You too.
Senator, before I go, one thing though, I did want to get your ear on.
Okay.
I am a CVPS customer. Okay. I want the $16 million they were supposed to give us back a long time ago. Okay, now they don't want to give it back to us from what I can gather. I don't know, you're up there. I can only follow it from, you know how it goes.
I think it's a bit more complicated than it sounds.
Yeah, I figured it was.
And you would end up getting maybe $70.
Yeah, or $150.
So if everybody
could be from $70, it depends on if you want to pay businesses back or.
Right, but why shouldn't businesses get paid back?
Because they get to write it off, I don't.
Not all businesses get it.
Then let them have it. But I just think big businesses who get to write it off shouldn't be allowed to. I mean, if they can write it off, they're getting reimbursed. I'm not. The deal was. I'm just letting you know how I feel. I'm gonna call you anyway.
Okay. And the deal was that you'd get back in value, not necessarily cash. I'm not a CVPS customer, so.
I just remember when I got the mailing.
And that said you were gonna mail them
out. That's all. And how many corporations do they tell us one thing and then later we're looking at one down in the southern end of the state that they make all these deals and then the next thing I know I'm getting shoved out the back.
Well, I think that the Department of Public Service, come on, do you need a plate for your car?
I'm going to let you start selling plates today. I'll talk to you another time,
okay?
I'll get you.
But
thank you. Good.
And we're working on it. Yes.
Any action on S-138 this week?
Oh yeah, S-138. You guys took
What's
it off the floor. That's the decrim bill, but I think you're going to do a study on it. You brought it up on Tuesday, I think.
Well, we're not doing a study on it.
Email will work.
I know. I've got an amendment that I'm sticking someplace else.
Okay, good. We'll pay attention to that, though.
All right.
Thanks a lot, Jeanette. Bye. Thanks for being out here selling the plates.
Are you going to get a plate?
Okay, you ready?
Yeah.
I am with
Robin White.
And Robin White? Are you?
Not related.
I can't. I'm like, oh, then she says Robin White. I'm like, so you're related to her? She's not. Okay, well, there's an awful lot of whites walking in this street right here. Okay, so Robin, hi. Who do you, what do you do?
I'm a crisis counselor.
And for?
Washington County Mental Health got the grant from FEMA, so we're grant funded. And we provide in Windham County emotional crisis counseling for anyone affected by the hurricane. We also have a wealth of resources that we can refer you to besides the crisis counseling. We're putting on events locally to get survivors together. There's a free art class coming up that I'm working with River Gallery School at the end of the month on the 29th. And then you can come to this art class for free if you've been affected in any way.
Yep. And where's that at? Is it right at the school right up here?
River Gallery School, yep. Right here in Brattleboro. You can RSVP to me at 249-3628.
That's 249?
249-3628.
Very good.
And then if you want crisis counseling services, you can call the 800 number. It's 1-855-767-8800. In any county in the state, they'll connect you with a crisis counselor. There's no charge for the service. It's absolutely free. It's all funded by the federal government.
So if somebody needs somebody to talk to in Windham County, they should definitely get a hold of you.
Absolutely. I'm the person.
Do you have an office in town or around?
It's called my car. And at home, I'm on the email. And a lot of my big push right now is to really celebrate the resilience of Vermonters.
Yeah.
So I can do the crisis counseling, which I'm happy to do. But I'm also trying to work with the schools to create events, to have the kids really, in some way, look at what we've overcome. There's been a lot of tragedy in Windham County. Wilmington and Brattleboro both have had their fair share.
Yes, we have.
That's my focus. Yep. So, any ideas you have, any way that I can help, but mostly I just want people to know that I exist and what I'm doing, and you know, we've got some great events coming up. And, yeah.
So again, folks, if you were affected by Hurricane, the flood of Irene, please get a hold of Robin White right here at, where can they call you again?
My cell is 249-3628, or you can call the 800 number, and they can connect you also on
that. And that number is going to be put on the, you can say it, but we're going to put it on the thing.
Okay, 855-767-8800. And like I said, there's the art event at the end of the month. We've paired up with the Empathy Cafe team, and we're doing that as a way to build community among survivors. Really look at how are you still affected today by the hurricane? I mean, some people lost everything,
yeah.
And these needs are ongoing. And there's also a lot of volunteers coming into our community to help with spring cleanup. So you can contact us. We can't make any promises, but we're going to connect you to what's out there. And there's a lot of good people. All the money from the plates, you know, that $18, it's going to a fund that we're making sure the people who need the money are getting it.
Excellent. Good. Thank you very much for your hard work, Robin.
Yeah,
we appreciate
you're welcome.
That.
Thank you.
That's your parking spot, number one.
Hey, just up there. Yeah, TV.
No parking sign. Are you guys home? Are you done?
Yeah, no, we're home just for Easter break.
How are you doing, man? Hey, we hope you enjoyed this edition of the Pulse of Brattleboro. As you can see, Gallery Walk, a typical but Gallery Walk. Wasn't quite as busy as normal. A lot of stuff going on. I like to try and get the nonprofits and let people know what's going on and what's coming up, and it helps them out. And as you can see, a lot of kids do it too, and they volunteer. So, you know, give you a little music, stuff like that. So, me and Joe hope you enjoy the show. Joe would love it if somebody would just give him an email, and you can get a hold of him by just going to pulseofbrattleboro@yahoo.com. Again, that's pulseofbrattleboro@yahoo.com. Please send them something, okay? Say, yes, we watch the show, we like it, we don't like it, you should do this, you should do that, something different. But anyway, another successful Gallery Walk. Joe ate tons of chocolate, and we spent all of our little bit of dollars we had on us helping everybody. I got my Vermont is Strong license plate, so it was a successful Gallery Walk. So again, we hope to see you right here
next time. This is this was the April gallery walk, so we'll see you in May. And don't forget our June Strolling of the Heifers. It's a biggie coming up in just 2 more months, so be ready and look out for that one. Again, for my cameraman Jojo, say goodbye.
Goodbye, Joe.
And thank you, BCTV, for letting us put this show on. This is Daryl Pillsbury. Oh, hey, Steve West, too. We want to thank you for our song now. That's an original from Steve West.
One Too Many Stars.
So, and it's called One Too Many Stars. One Too Many Stars. And it's an original by Steve West. And he's now our song. So thank you, Steve. That's it. Another show. We'll see you.
Pulse of Brattleboro.
Yep, Pulse of Brattleboro.
Over and out.
And we'll see you later. All right, let's get the push the walk button for dog.
Watch the Pulse of Brattleboro on BCTV.